Hello everyone, today we are going to be talking all about glass dip pens. Now, a lot of you may have heard of these and you might be wondering, do these really live up to all the hype? And so I will answer some questions and I will give you my final review and if I think that they are worth all of the hype. So let's first talk about what they are. A glass dip pen is essentially a pen that you can dip into liquid inks or watercolor. They write extremely smooth and they are similar to a juicy fountain pen. The ink is trapped in the beveled chamber and it flows down with gravity as you write. They are super elegant and they are beautiful and I love the way that the ink flows. It really is like a juicy fountain pen, but you can change the colors as much as you like. This one comes with a little brush rest or a pen rest and a bottle of ink. And they are super delicate, obviously, because they are made of glass. So you have to be extremely careful. And if you don't, the tip can easily break. And if the tip breaks, then that's pretty much the pen for you because that's what you need in order to write. So you don't want any chips or flaws in the beveled area or the nib. So let's now talk about how you use them. So first of all, you need some sort of ink or liquid watercolor. It must be in the liquid form, and you're gonna notice as I show you the different kind of inks that you want a specific type of ink. So first you're going to dip your pen in the ink. You can do it about either halfway all the way up to the full way of the beveled edges. And then you want to make sure that the ink isn't going to drip first before you take it out. So you can give it a swipe on the edge of the jar and then you can just go ahead and start writing. Now, a good dip pen can hold a lot of ink and you won't need to re-dip for a while. And I'll show you a little bit later on in the video how much I can write with just a single dip. I think some people are under the impression that you have to re-dip frequently, and that is actually not the case. If you want to change colors, then you can rinse your pen in water. And then I would dry it off on a towel to make sure that you don't have any excess moisture. And then you can just re-dip it in a different color. And that's how you would use multiple colors. Now, are all dip pens the same? And the answer is no. There are tons of different companies who make glass dip pens. And some of them are not good at all. I have owned another one and I can tell you the ink just didn't flow at all, and so I would get lots of spots and then I would just have random blobs. So it really depends on how the design is, and I can say that this one I really like. I haven't had many issues with it and the ink flows pretty consistently, so the design and the pen can make a difference. I've had a lot of people tell me that they can't get their ink to flow, and sometimes it has to do with how the pen is made. Some are not made very well, and so the ink does not flow down the beveled area. I would just say that before you purchase it, check the reviews and see if there are good reviews or bad reviews, because most people are brutally honest when it comes to if their product isn't working very well. People will leave reviews and let them know, like, hey, the ink isn't flowing very well. So just make sure you check that, because I wouldn't want you to purchase a product that doesn't work very well, because I have done that with my first glass dip pen and it was just a waste of money. So there are a few different kinds of inks that you can use with them, and the one that I highly recommend is the Royal Talons Ecoline Liquid Watercolor. It is so smooth And then also the ink that comes with it was also very smooth. I didn't have any issues with it. Now, some people like these Dr. P.H. Martin's iridescent inks. And for some reason, I could not get those to work for me at all. Also, people like the Winsor & Newton calligraphy ink. And you have to be careful with the ones that have glitter or sparkles, because I think that prevents it from flowing smoothly down off the pen. So I just highly recommend the Royal Talons Ecoline Liquid Watercolor, because I have never had issues with it and it flows so smooth. You won't have issues at all with it blotting or skipping. And it also helps that they have a huge variety of colors, so that makes it easy to write colorful things, and it just really looks beautiful when you use a bunch of colors, especially with the liquid watercolor. Also, you just want to remember that when you're done, you just swirl it around in water and then wipe it on a paper towel or a cloth towel, just to make sure there's no excess moisture or ink on there. Now, this is the Dr. P.H. Martin's iridescent calligraphy ink, and I have a very difficult time getting this to work smoothly, and I think it's because of the glitter that is in there. If you see when I'm starting to write, it looks like it's going smooth, and then all of a sudden it just blots on me just like that. And it can be really frustrating, especially if you're, let's say, addressing envelopes or doing something of that nature and you have to redo it because now you can't fix that blot. So I would just make sure every kind of ink that you decide to try out, make sure you test it and write quite a bit with your glass dip pen just to make sure that you don't have any issues like that, because that is extremely frustrating when that happens and then you have to start all over. So just test them out, because what works for me and does not work for me might work for you, especially if you're using a different pen. Now, this Winsor & Newton ink I also have difficulty with, and I think it's because of all the different elements that are in there with the gold and then the liquid. It kind of is not just a watery substance, but it's a little bit thicker. So as you can see, when I'm starting to write, it just doesn't flow down the pen. And like I said before, with the glitter that is in the ink, you have to be very careful because it can make it very splotchy. And so it can be really unpredictable. If anybody has used these with a glass dip pen, let me know, because I'd love to know how it flows for you or what pen you're using that it is successful with. So let me know down below in the comments if you have gotten these to work for you. Now, the next product that I like to use are these sparkly metallic watercolors. Now, when you're using watercolors, you have to make sure you add a lot of water, because you have to give it a liquidy, watery texture. So when you do that, you have to let it sit for a little while, and then I even add a little more water, and then you have to swirl it, your paintbrush around in there, and then you're pretty much painting the nib. Now, when you're doing this, you want to make sure that before you write on your paper, you swipe it on the edge of a jar or on the edge of something to make sure it doesn't drip all over your paper like mine does. So I'm a good example of what not to do, but it does have a really nice effect, and you can use multiple different colors. But you just have to make sure you have the right consistency. More water is better. It will dilute the color a bit, but you have to have the watery texture, otherwise it's not going to work for you. Now, what paper is best for glass dip pens? You want to use a thicker paper, like a watercolor paper. It can be cold pressed or hot pressed. That's really preference for people. You can use a mixed media paper. I typically use watercolor paper. And then on the right is the hot press paper, and it has a nice smooth texture. And then on the left is a cold press paper. Those are from Hana Mule, and they have different textures, as you can see. I'm going to test both so you can see what they look like. So the first one I'm going to test out is the hot press paper. Now, if you don't like the rough bumps, then hot press paper is for you. The pen glides so smooth on the paper, and it is nice because the paper is still thick. It's 140 pound weight, so it's still thick enough to withstand that ink. You would not want to use just a regular piece of copy paper with a glass dip pen, because you actually are putting a lot of liquid onto the paper, as much as it may not seem like you are. So if you're crossing over in certain sections, you could eventually tear your paper if it's not strong enough to withstand all of that liquid in one concentrated area. So now onto cold press paper. This one obviously has a lot more texture. I would avoid the rough texture paper, because if it does have too much tooth to it, then sometimes the watercolor can expand and feather in those really deep grooves. So just be careful with that. But I never have had any issues with the cold press paper, despite it having a little bit of texture. Cold press paper is what I prefer using, and if you follow me on Instagram, then you'll see that most of my posts with the glass dip pen are used in conjunction with cold press paper. Now the question I always get, how much can you write before re-dipping your pen? And I'm gonna show you can write a ton before re-dipping. It surprised me the first time I started writing with this thing how much it could actually write before I had to re-dip. So as you can see, I write the entire alphabet and numbers up to 50. Now obviously, as we get closer to 50, it's starting to get a lot lighter and a little spotty in areas. So it just gives you a good idea of how much you can write, though, before you even re-dip. And I really love that, because if you're writing a lot, obviously you don't want to be dipping your pen tons of times throughout the time of you writing. So it's nice that you can write as long as you want and change the color if you want. It just makes it really convenient to have a really beautiful writing and not have to switch pens or get a different color or anything like that. So how do you switch colors? I will go more in depth into this. First, you're going to start with whatever color you like. I have a blue and a teal color. So first I'll write with the color I choose, and then you're going to take your water, swirl your pen in the water, and then just swipe it on a cloth, or I just have a paper towel, and then you can dip it into the next color. And you really just repeat this, so it's not a big deal. You do want to make sure that you rinse off your brush, though, before dipping it into the next color ink, because you can absolutely change the colors of the ink in your bottle. So just make sure you clean off the color, unless you don't mind mixing colors, then go for it. And now, how should you store your pen? So mine came in this case that's padded, and it came with this plastic protector. So put the plastic protector back on, and then I like nest it in the container it came in that has a nice foam, and then I just put the lid back on. There's no fancy way of storing this. you really have to be careful and just make sure you take care of it, because if you break any part of it, it's going to affect the way that the pen writes. So you just have to be careful and take care of it, and then you can have some beautiful glass dip pen writing. Another thing you want to remember is that this is not a brush pen and it doesn't work on pressure sensitivity. So like right here, I'm doing some faux lettering by adding the extra line. It's not like a brush pen. You can't add pressure and it's going to make that thick downstroke. So just as an FYI, in case people weren't aware, you can't do that. You have to make it on your own.